Welcome to the long range forecast for you as a Sagittarian, covering the whole of 2009. We can't go hour by hour, moment by moment through the year ahead. We can't really even go week by week, and even if we were to give you a quick month by month summary, to what extent it would be useful is questionable. A great deal of the future is not set in stone. You have the option to make it less predictable than it might be if you were to simply take the path of least resistance. If you want to take the path of least resistance, what do you need a horoscope for? Why consult an astrologer, unless it's to have an excuse not to make an effort? Oh, there's no point in doing this because the astrologer has told me that that's what's going to occur. So I just tell you to steel yourself for a relatively ordinary time during which lots of challenges arise, then you can do that very thing, and probably I'll be right, and probably you'll, well, what will you feel? Glad because you were limited, because your options were restricted, because you set your expectations low? I don't think so. In fact, I don't think that you need to do that this year, and it would be very good if you were to prove that all sorts of predictions and prophecies were wrong. You are in a position to do that. You have enormous power, not only to alter your quote-unquote destiny, but to change the way that things look for many of the people around you. We're entering a phase where, according to many folk, there are a great bunch of options that won't be available to us. The world is taking a break from prosperity. Hard times are around every corner, and they may well get a lot worse for a lot longer before they get better. Or so the great pundits and experts have to say, of course. They don't know, because nobody knows, because the future is not yet written, and even an astrologer has to be extremely careful before making great pronouncements about what is yet to come, because what is yet to come has not come. But you are in a position to take what has not come and totally turn it round so that whatever you expect to be coming is not what's coming at all. You're being blessed now with tremendous power, with great reserves of strength, with resources which are impressive and enviable. And these are not just resources of the nature of wisdom or insight or intelligence. We're looking to material resources. Even if you may consider yourself to be very short of what's required to make a difference at a physical level, somehow you're going to be blessed this year with the ability to achieve whatever it is that you most need, to support whatever cause it is that you most give your heart and soul to. And there, in a nutshell, is the clue to it all. It is in the giving of your heart and soul, in the commitment of your passion and your energy, not necessarily to a relationship or to anything as prosaic as a romance, but to something as gloriously idealistic and magnificent as a concept, a notion, a cause. In what do you believe? In whom do you believe? In what principle, what idea, what great change you would like to help bring about? Where's your belief in a brighter world and your dream of what might be possible that could change something for the better for everyone? It's there, in that territory, that energy now needs to be deployed. Not just because you'll feel good when you do it, but because you, of all people on this planet, are in a position to make a difference, to make a contribution that really counts. And all year long, every time you find yourself getting stuck, caught up in the day-to-day grind, the nitty-gritty, the trial and tribulation, the argument and the aggravation that accompanies existence on planet Earth, don't allow yourself to feel frustrated or thwarted. Don't descend to the petty level that some people seem to enjoy nurturing conflict at. Rise to the point of great vision and hope and inspiration and ask yourself, yes, but what really matters? What was I born to do? What is beautiful about life? What is amazing about existence? And how can I intensify my own experience of all that's magical and help others fulfill the height of their potential too? Too airy-fairy, too head in the clouds, not realistic enough for a year during which the world's getting ready for hardship and difficulty and all kinds of recession-related problems? Well, you know what? You want to participate in the doom and the gloom which is prevalent at the moment? Feel free, go right ahead. You won't meet many people who are telling you that there is an option. But you have met me, and I am telling you, what, well, we've met, even if we haven't met, we're meeting now. I'm telling you what I understand to be absolutely true about you as a Sagittarian in this year. It doesn't matter what's going on. It doesn't matter who believes what, because if you believe that what you're doing is important enough, and if your heart and soul and your commitment to what matters are right there being given, then the difference will be made, the change will be effected, and all the needs which have to be met will be met, regardless of how against all odds that appears to be. Existence is against all odds. Life is against all odds. Happiness, it often seems, is against all odds. You've got everything against as many odds as you like to make sure that this year miracles don't just happen, they are celebrated and deeply enjoyed.
It's all in your mind.